Hi, welcome to the series of video lectures on microwave engineering. In this session, we will discuss what is circulator. This circulator is a device which uses again the principle of Faraday rotation. Now, let us see what is the circulator is. The circulator is a four-port microwave device which has a peculiar property that each terminal is connected only to the next clockwise terminal. That is, port 1 is connected to port 2 only, but not to port 3 and 4. Similarly, port 2 is connected to port 3, but not to port 4 and port 1, etc. See here, this is the circulator. This is the 4-port circulator, which is shown in clockwise direction. So, this is the 4 port 1, port 2, port 3 and port 4. What is its operation? Port 1 is connected to port 2, but not to port 3 and port 4. Similarly, port 2 is connected to port 3 and port 3 is connected to port 4 only. Again, port 4 is connected to port 4 1 only. So that means if the signal is fed into port 1, it will come out of port 2 only. It will not come out of port 3 and port 4. The rest of operation, the similar operation occurs when the input is given to port 2, port 3 and port 4. Simple operation is, when the input signal is given to port 1, it comes out of port 2, but it will not come out of port 3 and port 4. So let us see, these circulators are used in parametric amplifiers, tunnel diode amplifiers and as duplexer in radars. So these circulators find various applications in microwave circuits such as parametric amplifiers, tunnel diode amplifiers, which is as a duplexer in radar systems. Now, say this is the construction of circulator. Here you can see this. This is rectangular. This rectangular is converted into circular waveguide. So, which is shown as rectangular to circular waveguide, where TE10 wave is given as vertically polarized, is given as input. It will be converted into TE11 dominant mode because of this rectangular to circular transition. The port T here, port 1, this is port 1, this is port 2. Port 2 is 45 degrees twisted with respect to port 1, which is shown here. The port 3 is here and port 4 is here. This is a ferrite rod which provides Faraday rotation of 45 degrees in the clockwise direction. Let us see what happens when the wave is given to port 1, how it comes at port 2. Similarly, when the signal is given to port 2, how it comes at port 3. Let us see in the coming sessions. The wave entering port 1, that is TE10 mode, is converted to TE11 mode because of rectangular to circular transition, which I have explained earlier. This is the TE10 wave which we have given as input. Because of this rectangular to circular transition, this TE10 wave is converted into TE11 mode. Now, this wave passes port 3. This TE11 wave passes port 3. Port 3 unaffected, since the electric field is not significantly cut. See, this TE11 wave passes this port 3 unaffected, since the electric field is not cut by this port 3 and is rotated through 45 degrees in clockwise direction due to ferrite rod. Because of this ferrite rod, this wave is rotated, the plane of polarization is rotated 45 degrees in clockwise direction, and this wave passes port 4 unaffected, since this port 4 also do not cut the electric field significantly, and finally emerges out of port 2. So this is the, that's why the signal given to port 1 comes out of port 2. Let us see what we have to write. So in the examination, when the signal is given to port 1, it is converted into TE11 mode. This TE11 mode passes this port 3, because this electric field is not significantly cut by this port 3, and it undergoes a Faraday's rotation of 45 degrees because of ferrite rod, and also passes port 4 unaffected because this port 4 also do not cut this wave significantly, and it will come out of port 2 because this port 2 is suitably aligned to receive this signal. So therefore, the input given to port 1 will come out of port 2, but it will not come out of port 3 and port 4. So that is what we have written here. Similarly, when the wave entering into port 2 will have plane of polarization already tilted 45 degrees with respect to port 1. This wave passes port 4 unaffected because the electric field is not significantly cut. This wave gets rotated another 45 degrees due to ferrite rod in clockwise direction. Let us see what is this. So that means the wave entering into port 1, because this port 2 is already twisted 45 degrees with respect to port 1, the wave undergoes a plane of polarization of 45 degrees when it enters into port 2, and it passes port 4 unaffected because this port 4 will not significantly cut this electric field. This signal, whose plane of polarization 45 degrees rotated because of port 2, twisted port 2, gets again 45 degrees rotation because of this ferrite rod. So therefore the total plane of polarization of the wave changes by 90 degrees because of this 45 degrees twist here, 45 degrees ferrite rod. This wave, whose plane of polarization tilted by 90 degrees, finds port 3 suitably aligned and emerges out of it. When the wave entering into port 2, because of 45 degrees, its plane of polarization changes by 45 degrees. When it crosses ferrite rod, the plane of polarization further changes by 45 degrees. So therefore, the total plane of polarization change is 90 degrees. And this wave finds port 3 suitably aligned to it, and therefore it receives the signal. So therefore, the signal given to port 2 will come out of port 3 and will not come out of port 4 and port 1. Similarly, the port 3 is coupled to port 4 and port 4 is coupled to port 1, which we have explained in this diagram earlier. Let us see what are the applications of these circulators. There are three applications we have mentioned here. So the first application is, the circulator is used as a duplexer in radar systems. Let us see. The circulator can be used as duplexer for radar antenna system as shown here. So this is the circulator. This is port 1, port 2, port 3 and port 4. Port 1, the radar transmitter is connected. Port 2, antenna is connected. Port 3, radar receiver is connected. Port 4 is provided with matched termination. See, when the radar transmitter transmits a signal, so it is transmitted, the signal is given to antenna, because the signal is connected to the antenna. So therefore this antenna radiates the signal. When receiving the signal, the received signal is transmitted to the receiver because of the circulator property. The signal coming to port 2 is coupled to port 3. Therefore, when the antenna receives the signal, it directs the signal to the radar receiver but not to the radar transmitter. So therefore, the same antenna can be used as transmitter as well as receiver. So therefore, this circulator provides isolation between radar transmitter and radar receiver. That therefore, it functions as a duplexer. When transmitting the signal, the signal which is to be transmitted is connected to the antenna, while receiving, the received signal is connected to the receiver. So this is how the circulator is used in radar systems. Second one, the three-port circulator can be used in tunnel diode or parametric amplifiers as shown here. Here a three-port circulator is shown. This is the three-port circulator is shown. In this, the anti-clockwise three-port circulator, port 1 is connected to port 2 and port 2 is connected to port 3. This is the anti-clockwise three-port circulator. Here the input is given to port 1. So here it is given to tunnel 2. The tunnel diode amplifies the signal. This amplified signal is given to port 3. This is another circulator, three-port circulator. So therefore this amplified signal is given to port 1, which will come out as output at port 2. So the port 3 is again provided with the matched termination. So this is the second application in tunnel diode amplifiers. The third application is, circulators can be used as low power devices as they can handle low powers only. Since they handle low powers, they can be used in low power devices. So this is the circulator, very very important article in the examination. Circulator, this is the how the circulator operates. This is the construction of construction of circulator. So how the signal traveling from port 1 is connected to port 2 is explained, and how the signal traveling from port 2 is connected to port 3 is also explained. So these are the applications of circulators in microwave circuits. Thank you.